Hello everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we were talking about Nest.js with MongoDB, and if you remember, then we have created a customer module and a database module. So in database module we already have the MongoDB connection. Here we are using Mongoose module from Nest.js Mongoose, and we are providing the MongoDB URL. You can do it different way. You can have a Docker containers and Mongo and spin up the MongoDB container there and provide the host for the MongoDB. Currently this is running somewhere, MongoDB, and I'm connecting to that. This is database module. I have provided the dependency of database module in my app module. Okay, and I have created this customer module in the last video where we are talking about all different APIs we are trying to access. Okay, here we are talking about Mongoose module. So in this feature module, we can call it as an entity module or a feature module because it is dealing with customer only, right? If you're creating any customer user module or something else where you wanted to access multiple MongoDB collections, then you can just pass that in the array of Mongoose module.forFeature. So here we are passing name customer and the schema is customer schema. Here you can just create the object and specify other MongoDB collection you wanted to access in this particular module, like name can be user schema is user schema. Now after doing this, we are able to access the customer model in our controllers and services. So here in service, if we just go to customer service, here we are able to access the customer schema model and we are able to run the operations like customer model.find. Similarly, we are going to create another method is create. So here we can say create customer, and it is going to return customer in the promise. Okay, here you might be getting the customer object. So what we will do is we have this customer model. So there are different ways to save create a new collection, new document inside a collection. Here we are not talking about the MySQL terminologies like table, columns. We call the table as a collection and we call record as a document. So here we should have the different methods. One of them is a save. Save method, and you pass the object of what you wanted to save, like customer model I'm creating. So I can this dot customer model. Okay, this customer model is of type customer, and here if you see, we can actually go inside it, the model definition, what all it is having. Module.exportlib. So this is actually the library about the MongoDB, and here you can see all the different things about a particular model, like the collections, where queries, events, middlewares. Okay, so you can also look at the library, what this particular Mongoose library is written in TypeScript and what all it is providing, the interface and all. Here, how we can actually save a new user, right? That for that we will create, we have created this method, create customer. Similarly, we can have another methods, update customer. Right, so here we will be just doing something like find customer and update, something like this. Find by ID and update. That methods we can see, like find by ID and remove, there is a method. So if you wanted to know get customer, then there is a method remove customer also. And on the customer, in the customer model, find by ID and remove should be one of the method. And it is just accepting the ID. So it will just first find it and then remove that record of that customer ID. Here it is get customer, so find by ID and update. So there will be some kind of a payload also we will be getting. So payload we are passing here. Okay, I have just written the sample examples. These are not the absolutely correct one. We will check these. Coming to the controller, what we have done is we have these two methods, right? Now we can create a REST APIs for that. So this is the get. This can be another can be for delete. This can be like delete, where we should be able to delete a customer based on customer ID. Okay, there can be another method which is update. So here it will become put. Still we are accepting the customer ID which you wanted to update. Customer ID, and in the request we will accept some payload. So it is like a put, so it will also have payload. So we will have a request body. A requeue of type request. Okay, now we'll be doing something like the payload is request.body. You will be sending and get customer. So similarly we'll have one method update customer. Update customer should be able to take the ID and customer object. So you can write this in different ways. First we can just try to find the customer. Okay, const find by ID. So it should actually return, we are doing find by ID and we are passing ID. So if we got customer, I mean if some user exists with that ID, then only we will try to remove that and we will try to update it. So we got the customer. If customer is there, then why there is a warning? Await this dot customer model dot find by ID. If we got the customer, then we will be able to update it. So here we can see await this dot customer model. So there are different methods to do it. So first what you can do is if the customer is available, customer you got, now you can set all the properties to the customer only. Customer dot property name, and we might be getting something from the pay request body, right? Property name, we are getting the individual property name from the request body and set it, and finally you can say customer dot save, something like that, right? It will actually save our customer object. Okay, I mean just find by ID and update, find by ID and delete, all these methods are kind of same. So what we will do is we will just try to explore more on the MongoDB and we'll try to finish up this particular controller and service in the next video.